Hello, I am André from Flanders. Let me first give you an explanation about the two types of marketing. Let's imagine that you are selling computers. If you sell computers to professionals like lawyers, butchers, garage, you are making horizontal marketing. But if you specialized, for an example, in dentist, and you sell only to dentists, that's what we call vertical marketing. And this is an important difference in the explanation that I will give you now about the spreading of ideologies in the world. Hello. I will start with an explanation about one folk. For the example, I will take my own folk, Flanders. In one folk, you have youth, you have workers, and you have retired people. Around them, you have company animals, wild animals, trees, river, and ground. And the ideal for a folk is a vertical harmony between all those elements, between youth and retired people, between youth and workers, between people and animals, and between people, animals, and the environment. That's what I call the vertical harmony. Now, next door, from Flanders, you have Holland, who speaks the same language as in Flanders. In the Netherlands, you have young people, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, trees, water, and ground. And for them too, the best way is vertical harmony between young workers, retired people, animals, environment. Next door, speaking the language directly related to Flemish and Dutch, is Germany. Germany have also youth people, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, trees, water, and ground. And for German, it's the same. The logic way is harmony between the generation and workers, harmony with animals, and harmony with environments. So it means a vertical harmony is also good for them. Directly related as the map of the population of Europe shows, you have Scandinavia. Scandinavia has youth, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, tree, water, and ground. And for them too, the idea of the harmony is the harmony between the generation with the animals and with the environments. For them too, the way is vertical harmony. On the northeast of Europe, you have the Baltic Sea with Balts and Russians from the west, and they are also youth people, wild animals, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, trees, water and ground. This is what I call Nordlandia, the pale zone that you see on the map attached to this video. Now, here you have south of Europe. In south of Europe, they also have young people, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, trees, water, and ground. Then you have country like England, USA, Commonwealth, Israel, that are part of the Western civilization. They also have youth people, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals. In their environment, they have tree, water, and ground. And for them too, the harmony, the ideal harmony is vertical harmony. Then you have the rest of the world. And in the whole world, you have young people, workers, retired people, company animals, wild animals, tree, water, and ground. So, how can you define what is friend, what is not friendly? It's very simple. First, I want to make a difference here, up to here, Netherlands, Germany, Scandinavia, northeast of Europe. I call it Nordlandia. And South Europe, England, USA, and Commonwealth are people that are living in Israel, are people that are living like us. And the rest of the world are very often a different way of life. Now, what says the enemy? The enemy says, workers of the whole world unite. In other words, he makes a horizontal marketing. And that's what you trace back in ideologies like communism, saying workers of the whole world unite, or international capitalism, or even world theories like Christianism or Islam today, that all want to dominate the world with horizontal marketing. While I preach for two things. First, defining our how glad they are interested, and grow in vertical harmony with gradually to the environment. What is also interesting to see is that when a guy of extreme left claims about acid rain on our trees, or trees of Germany, of trees of Scandinavia, of Baltic Rhea, he does something positive for us, while people preaching world theories like communism, international speculation, Christianism, Islam, and they gave priority by us to refugees from the rest of the world coming by us with a better pension, better benefits than people from our own country. They are enemies. And that's the difference between, let's say, a natural growth between neighbors of people having a common way of life, common way of having children. If someone from the rest of the world comes here and has by us 6 children, where we used to have 2, is breaking the social contract that we have established for us here. In fact, demography of the third world bias is today used as a war tool at the expenses of our naive democracies. So keep in mind the difference between vertical harmony and horizontal harmony of world theories like communism, Islamism, Christianism, that are introducing by us values that are not our Nordlandia values. So this is the difference between, the sociologic difference between vertical and natural growth of the harmony and the horizontal dogmatic of world theories. Thanks for your interest. Bye bye. A few words about this uniform. The idea is very simple. It's a copycat of the work that Salvation Army is doing mostly in the rest of the world, but by doing it for our own poor and retired people in Northern Europe. Northern Europe is very often related to the sea, and that's why by us it will be a Hansa Marine. About the use of this mask, I live in Belgium and I live daily in a city where the mayor has been elected with the support of Muslim vote. So I'm scared for my life, wife, children. I'm scared for my property, and I want to remain anonymous as long as I can. I'm in the front line.